video, I am showing you exactly what I eat in a day to lose weight. Eating the meals that I'm gonna show you every single day, I was able to lose 20 pounds in 3 months and 6% body fat. And I'm still losing inches because every day that I put on my clothes, they're getting bigger. And these are the smaller clothes, look at that. These are the smaller clothes that I ordered after losing the 20 pounds. That's crazy, like these clothes are getting so big. So let's start with meal one. The first thing I do when I wake up is I drink a black cup of coffee. One, because I love it. Two, it gives me energy and focus to do my cardio. And I don't put anything in my coffee because if I'm in a calorie deficit, I would rather eat my calories than drink them. So I prefer black coffee. And then I eat a protein bar. I like the pure protein ones because they are the best macros for what we can get here. And I ate a chocolate coconut one. It's one of my favorites. Then breakfast. So that's like a pre-breakfast. For breakfast, I love French toast. I eat it with egg whites, cinnamon, stevia, zero calorie sweetener, and I like the Villaggio Artisano bread because it's 150 calories for two slices. So I make that up, and then I usually have half a cup of thawed frozen fruit, and today it was strawberries. Sometimes it's peaches or mixed berries. Top it with Walden Farms because it's low calorie, and I love the different flavors. Today was regular pancake syrup, and then the pièce de résistance is the Swerve icing sugar substitute. It makes the French toast taste like the real thing.
The Swerve icing sugar is like a must have.
It's like the real deal, and I order it online. And by the way, we're not sponsored for any of the food that we're showing you. We eat it because we like it.
And you don't have to eat like Nicole. She's just showing you for interest and entertainment's sake.
Yeah, you don't have to eat like me. This is what works for me, but I love it. And that's the reason why I'm still getting leaner too, because I love my food every single day and it fuels me to do my cardio, which I do after breakfast. I do an hour of cardio 6 times a week. I go usually moderate, so like breathing hard, heart rate's up, but I can still hold a conversation.
Unfortunately.
Sassy doesn't really like that when I talk.
I'm walking beside her and it's a bit much.
So I either walk outside or I do the recumbent bike or the treadmill that we have in our basement. Most days I do moderate. Some days I've had the energy, I push myself a little harder, but mostly moderate. And I do that much cardio because I like to eat food. So I'd rather do more cardio and eat a little more food, and that helps me lean out. And I choose what I love to do for cardio. I don't force myself to do anything I don't like. Then after the cardio, like, I am starving. So I eat lunch. This lunch is so good. Like, I literally love every meal that I eat every day. So it's so easy to do this. Like, there's no track for me. People always say, how do you stay on track? There isn't a track because I like my food so I don't fall off. Sometimes I do give myself the real thing, but for the most part, I stick to this because I love it.
Like on the weekend, this past weekend, we were feeling a little run down, so we had a cheat day.
Yeah.
But that is part of the plan. Like, you can't just eat one diet, one set amount of calories for the rest of your life. No one sticks to that.
What you see in this video is what I eat 90% of the year, but every once in a while, if I'm feeling a bit low or like really hungry, then I give myself a cheat day and it gives me the fuel and the motivation I need to get back on eating this way. And I continue to lean out and look better every single day, and I'm loving it. Sometimes you gotta be human and give yourself treats. For the most part, love what you eat in a calorie deficit and you'll reach your goals. Well, I do anyway. Turkey wrap. I use lean turkey. I love the Joseph Lavash low carb wraps because you get a pretty decent size for a good amount of calories, and it keeps me full when I eat that wrap. And because it's bigger, I can load it with veggies. And I love the romaine lettuce, a little bit of baby spinach, cucumbers, because those really add volume. And I love eating things that I can add volume with very few calories because it keeps me full and satisfied. And I like to put a little bit of dressing in there. I like the calorie-wise Greek dressing. And I love black olives. Like, I've loved them since I was a kid. So I add 2 teaspoons of the dressing and then about a heaping teaspoon of sliced black olives. I do that, one, because I like black olives, and two, I eat pretty low in fat all day, so that adds a little bit of fat to my diet. And then I wrap it all up with 3 slices of lean turkey deli meat, and I, that was me eating it.
Thanks for the demonstration.
And I usually have a diet pop with that. Oh, and I forgot actually to mention, after the cardio, I drink 2 bottles of water and I take my vitamins. Why I do
your
that?
Vitamins?
My vitamins. Vitamins. I do bite them actually. Why I drink the water after the cardio is because I would pee my pants if I drank it before. There's no other reason. Because it's a long time, an hour of cardio out in the wilderness.
And that walk today was actually like close to an hour and a half, so.
That's true, because we went the long way because it was muddy in our normal way. So my vitamins, I take vitamin C and 3 vitamin D for immune system. Then I take a birth control for my PCOS because it gives me bad acne, but the birth control helps with that. And then I take a biotin and 2 chromium. And that's for my PCOS as well. The biotin helps with the hair loss that I get from having extra testosterone. It causes kind of like male pattern baldness. So I take that for that. And then the chromium helps with regulating your like insulin and blood sugar levels, which can be off when you have a hormone issue like PCOS. And I have a diet pop with lunch every day for no other reason than I like pop. I like diet pop, and it makes me love my life. And today I had the Diet Coke Extra Vanilla. That just came in regular cans. Oh my gosh, that stuff is good. For dinner, every night, low calorie pizza. Pizza is life. If you agree, let me know. So I eat low calorie pizza every night because I love it, and I just eat a low calorie version. I use the Joseph Lavash again, and I throw on whatever veggies that we like. Usually spinach, mushroom, peppers, onion, tomato, and some sort of hot pepper. Like right now we're into banana peppers. We like pickles and pineapple. Let me know if you're a pineapple on pizza person. It just adds that little like, what do you, je ne sais quoi. Just makes you like it better. Then we put 2 fat-free cheese slices on top. I like Black Forest ham. I use the lean kind, so it's like 50 calories for 3 slices. And to top it, I use a heaping teaspoon of light ranch dressing, and I just squink out the teaspoon because I gotta get all of it, and I just ploop it all over to make sure it's even. And then I do Guy's spicy sugar-free barbecue sauce, and I do the same, like a heaping teaspoonful, and you gotta splink out the teaspoon. You don't want to miss anything. And it really adds, and salt and pepper. For dessert, I eat, it's actually Greg Doucette's anabolic ice cream recipe, so you gotta check out his cookbook for that. But I topped it with a cinnamon bun fiber one and Lily's sugar-free chocolate chips. I used 10 grams and it's the sea salted caramel, I think it's called. It's like my favorite flavor of chocolate chips. It's delicious. And that really fills me up. And then for a snack, Smart Pop. I was being popcorn.
I figured that.
Maybe, but they might not know. You're used to me being popcorn, but they might not know I was being popcorn. So I eat a whole bag of Smart Pop. I love that because it's low fat. I love sweet and salty stuff. So like the ice cream was the sweet, the popcorn's the salty. I love watching movies and eating popcorn. Fills me up. And I love topping it with Colonel's seasoning because I can literally get out any craving I want of a savory kind. So, you know, cheddar, ketchup, whatever you want, you get to choose it. And then my last meal of the night, cottage cheese, 1/2 cup, with some cocoa powder, zero calorie sweetener, and a tablespoon of natural peanut butter. And one peanut butter, because I love peanut butter, and two, the natural peanut butter adds a little bit of healthy fat, because I do eat low in fat, so I like to have some fat throughout the day. And I forgot to mention, I drink 4 bottles of water in this jug from dinner on for the rest of the night. With my cottage cheese, when I'm finished, I also have a tablespoon of this apple cider vinegar, the organic one with the mother, with 4 ounces of water, and I drink it through a straw. It's really hard on the enamel on your teeth. That's why I dilute it in the water and I drink it with a straw. And the reason I do it, it helps with digestion, helps with bloating, and it can help regulate your blood sugar levels. And forgot to mention, when I'm making my lunch, especially on the weekends, while I have all the stuff out, I'll often prep 2 or 3 lunches ahead of time, because when my meals are prepped, I have no excuse except to eat my lunch and not go off track and eat other stuff. And now we'll do the calorie breakdown. So this calorie breakdown is just approximate. For the day, it is 1,923 calories. Breakfast, including the protein bar, is 503 calories. Oh, I forgot to mention, with breakfast, I eat 1/2 cup of plain fat-free Greek yogurt with some stevia or zero calorie sweetener and vanilla. Lunch, 232 calories. Dinner, about 371 calories. And my snacks, which is the popcorn, the cottage cheese, and the ice cream, it's about 817 calories. So that's the breakdown. Now, if you look on the MyFitnessPal, I use that to calculate my calories, but it tells me my goal of calories for the day is 1,690, which is way too low for my activity level. I do a ton of cardio, plus I'm active, very active throughout the day. So I calculated my calories on tdecalculator.net, and that gave me a much more accurate amount of calories. It's all a ballpark, but 1900 seems to help me, fuel me enough to keep pushing in my cardio and to keep leaning out. So that's enough for my body. You might need more or less depending on your body. And 158 protein, 247 grams of carbs, 43 fiber, about 54 sugar, and 42 grams of fat. I'm 37, I'm 5'4", and I'm currently 145 pounds. If you don't know, I have actually lost a total of 130 pounds and kept it off for 6 years. If you want to know exactly what I ate to lose my first and next 50 pounds, including exact portions, meal plans, family-friendly recipes, check out the ebooks down below. It's all in there. Check out these videos. Hope you enjoyed this full day of eating and my stuff. Shake it till you're warm. Do this. Do. Wear these llama slippers because they're cute.
Oh, we enjoy your stuff. Don't worry.
One more run out. I almost slipped. Love you guys. Peace.
Out. See ya.
Remember, the friends, that weight loss isn't just about the number on the scale. It's also about here and here, heart and mindset. Fight through it. You can do it. Don't give up.